desolate.
And afflicted. The troubles of my heart are enlarged. O bring thou unto me my distress. Look upon my affliction and my pain, and forgive all my sins. Consider mine enemies, for they are many, and they hate me with cruel hatred. O keep my soul and deliver me. Let me not be ashamed, for I put my trust in thee.
Alright, so in those verses, David is openly expressing his thoughts and feelings about the things that are going wrong in his life. Instead of letting his feelings of loneliness and suffering overwhelm him, David chooses to put his trust in God. Okay, so everyone goes through difficult times in their lives, right? Who in here has been through a difficult time? Everybody, right? Okay, so some situations such as the changes of COVID, can cause us to experience fear, maybe a little anxiety, a little uneasiness, all these things, right? But just like David, we can call out to God for help and for safety. He is your safe place no matter what challenge you face in life, whether it's COVID, or you move, or whatever the case is, he is your safe place. So, I want you guys to kind of get up, if you would. Over here. We're going to do a little thing. Yeah, make sure you put your mask on. If y'all need to be closer to me, I'll just put mine on for you. Okay, so I'm going to read some sentences. Okay? And, or statements. And if this is true, can you look up and just look at it? If this is true, you got to jump up and down. Okay. Read a second part.
Don't get hurry.
All right. So, I love to sing. And I'll even do it with you. Okay, I love to sing. Right, okay. Okay. I have a brother or sister. Okay. I have ridden a bicycle. Okay. I have waved to someone I do not know. Okay. I have kept my family with chores around the house. I expect all y'all to jump to that one. Okay. I have seen someone I love feel sad. Okay. I have chickens as pets. I have been sick before. Sick, be anything. I have worried that I will not get to see my friends or any family because of COVID. Okay, I have worried about getting sick with the virus. Alright, thank you for your honesty. Okay, I have been afraid that someone I love will get sick. Okay, and I can jump for that one too because I have been fearful of my grandmother getting it. So, God is with us and cares for us even when we're afraid. God is bigger than your worries and your fears, even with
love.
COVID-19.
Love.
Even with the virus. Okay. So I'm gonna get into the actual lesson itself. And it's gonna be out of Mark 6. I'm not gonna read it, I'm just not gonna read all verses, but I'm just gonna tell you a little story. Who in here likes stories?
Me.
Okay, one day, Jesus' disciples were going across on a lake in a boat. Jesus did not go with them because he was spending time praying with God.
this like invisible plate something.
I know who it was. It was God.
It was Jesus.
Yeah, very good, guys. They were scared though. They thought it.
Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid.
Alright, so what Jesus is telling us there, the disciples, is that we don't have to be afraid. Okay, we can trust his peace and help us in our times and our cares. Alright. Why does Jesus allow scary things to happen, do you guys think?
I wonder that.
You wonder that yourself?
When you have a bad dream, it proves it's not real.
True. Who here has had bad dreams?
I had some twice in one night.
Really? Did you? Wow. Okay, so bad dreams can be terrifying and scary, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Yes, but we wake up and we realize that it was just a dream. And right?
It was.
Okay. We just need to realize that God is greater than even our fears, even if it's bad dreams, or even if it's COVID, which is what a lot of people are fearful of right now. And I can relate. do to feel more connected to Jesus in your life?
Go to church.
Go to church.
Read the Bible.
You're on fire.
And read pray.
And pray. Prayer is a very powerful tool that, you know, we don't utilize as much as we probably should. Reading our Bible. Yes, dear.
Read about it.
Read about it. Like reading different stories and certain things in the Bible,
mm-hmm.
and devotions. Those are our wonderful tools that we can use to feel God's presence around us even more. Okay? As tools that we probably don't utilize as much as we should. So that's something maybe we need to work on. In our Bible story, Jesus calmed the wind that was like a storm. Sometimes the hard things in your life can feel like storms. Sometimes we all do. Symbolically lay him down.
Yeah.
At his feet. And
okay. You know what?
What?
Like when monsters are trying to get out of the cage and before you baby get out.
Alright.
I should have put in the cage. Lost him in it. I'm afraid of being kidnapped.
Oh my.
I'm afraid of
that. I'm pretty sure about it. You got many people around you. Not allowed to happen. Okay?
All right, guys. Hey, we got some new news. I told you I was going to let y'all know tonight. And so I want to hear some noise from you folks. I want to hear that you are really excited. We have confirmed and reserved our spot at Caswell. We're on the docket for July the 26th to the 31st. And that's July 26th to the 31st. We are pumped. We are going to Caswell. We got our spot. If you are on the list and you are going and you know that you have told us that you're going, praise God. Awesome. We have all the information we're going to get to you. If you know there's no way that you're going to be able to make it July 26th to the 31st, listen. It's okay. Let us know, and we will try and find somebody to fill out that spot for you. But once again, that's July the 26th to the 31st. For those that signed up, we're going to get you some more information out. Also, for those who are looking for the activities, I want to encourage you to do this. Go to the YouTube page, which you should be on maybe later, I'm not sure right now. Anyway, go down to Lawnmower Man and replay Lawnmower Man. There is absolutely nothing wrong with playing that every morning. That's how, if I'm having a bad day, I turn Randy on. It's like Lawnmower Man or Cotton Eye Joe or something. And get up, get active for Jesus, and just know that we understand that some are not going to be able to be here, and we get it. So that's why we're doing this, so that we can still connect and still be in touch with each other. I'm trying to see if I have any more. You can also go to the youth tab on the website, which is shadygrovestaley.com. Click on that. Man, that is your own tab. You click on that, all the stuff and information for youth and youth related is going to be on there. And so we look forward to that and look forward to seeing you guys next week, same time, same channel, same place. And we're going to be shooting live as well so that we can have our youth lesson live. And we might even get Randy talked into doing a live activity. I don't know. I'm going to have to maybe, you know, coerce him somehow. Maybe put a little extra caffeine in the coffee or something. But we're going to try to get something together. Hey, guys, we miss you. We love you. We understand. Some are not able to be here. And listen, we understand. But we also want to still connect with you because we love you. You're our family. And so without further ado, I am going to ask Mr. Randy to come up and close us out in prayer. Listen, we love you, we miss you, and we hope you have an awesome week. And God bless you. We're praying for you. Brother Andrew, come on.
Amen. Let's pray. Dear kind and gracious Heavenly Father, we do thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for our sins. We thank you for our young people who know who Jesus Christ is. And we pray that many more will give us an opportunity to reach out and share, to build up, and to increase your kingdom. Praise Christ's name.